today's shoe pick.
I would say that the reaction of, well, just the reaction when he won was the complete antithesis of when Trump won.
Living in Texas?
Yeah.
I don't actually don't see the Confederate flag as much in Texas as people probably think we see it. Mm-hmm.
Girl, this is a quick, okay? Real quick. This head though.
Ooh, is it or is it the African American? No, it's not a museum of African American history and culture. There you go. The Smithsonian. The best thing about today is that my twist out came out right. Already winning.
Robert Dura is an amazing German artist who believed that
in large poor cities like Charleston, New Amsterdam, and Philadelphia, enslaved men, women, and children often worked in a variety of trades,
as domestics,
craftsmen, dock workers, and local vendors. Opportunities to meet, build relationships, and share information.
He's your favorite. Albert Dürer is my favorite German artist, yes.
They lived
nice to see
and rebelled together.
Because I've actually seen the actual
the dependency
piece.
On slave labor spread across North America
and
from Dutch New Amsterdam
he,
to British
Columbia. He's graphite,
well
I believe, to do it.
Okay.
I'll have to double check that, but it's almost like a sketch. Which is why I like the quote.
With the reliance on enslaved like populations, new laws define who was enslaved and who was free.
Art history major.
By 1750.
This one I love right here. It says she was a clever entrepreneur, Marianne Dubreuil, switched between her birth name and her former slave owner's name to secure the best deals. Now that is smart.
Yeah, surprising.
We're still in
the race.
We have not even we're going to have to make some moves and catch some more tomorrow when we come back.
You're supposed to
on both sides, they face danger on the battlefield, including Lexington, Cowpens, Yorktowns, and Bunker Hill.
Oh, snap.
Oh my gosh.
think this is amazing as an art and history major. With American Studies and African American Studies, also as one of my majors. This is an amazing experience. Alright, so we are on our way up out of slavery. Finally, we are on our way towards Reconstruction. Freedom for us, because let me tell you, it's hard to sit in there to see whips and shackles and stuff like that. And so we've now arrived at Reconstruction. We have reached the next level.
It's powerful. It's just because the museum treated unjustly. It's like, and I don't know what.
It's been an interesting experience thus far. Seen a lot. And all of it's very, very heavy. Like, you don't really understand or take into account the amount of sacrifices people made until you actually see shadows. It's one thing to think about it in your mind, but
like, express yourself like,
if you don't see it, it's not real to you, it's not tangible, it's hard for you to really take it all into account. And so the bottom part of the movie. We're now walking through Reconstruction and segregation. That's not really any better. So we'll see how it goes. I still have Ty with me.
I am here. I'm just trying to get free.
Y'all just trying to get free, but I don't know if we're gonna get free in this museum. For those of you that don't know, Booker T. Washington is probably one of the most illustrious alumnus of Hampton University.
I love Malcolm. Malcolm is my historic crush. If you have to have a crush of someone from history, no, that would be Malcolm.
So it's Historic Bay.
Historic Bay.
Historic Bay. Thank you.
I was rapping this morning. Oh my God, her pathway to the museum. They could walk right into the monument and President's Park over there.
So we just finished day one in the museum. We had like the best time. Well, I ain't gonna say we had the best time because a lot of the stuff was very heavy. But I'm looking forward to coming back tomorrow to see the other stuff that we missed. We did downstairs today. Tomorrow we'll do upstairs. There's a lot of people in there. I'm sure tomorrow will probably be the same thing as the weekend. But so much fun. See you soon.